Hello wonderful people, this is Chris from Combo and I'm here with the Honor 9 Lite. So of course we had the Honor 9 flagship phone last year, 2017. Now, start of 2018, Honor has put out a Lite version of that phone. So basically a slightly cut back in terms of specs and features, but also coming in at a more affordable price. Unfortunately, we don't actually have that price at the time of shooting this video because it's pre-launch. It doesn't actually launch until tomorrow here in the UK. So by the time you see this video, it will have launched and we should know the price, so check out the description. Hopefully I'll have remembered to have put it in there. Touch words. So let's do a full unboxing anyway, get it all set up and everything, and then you can see exactly what you can expect from the Honor 9 Lite. So here's the actual phone itself. We'll just put that aside for one moment, just check out the rest of the box. I'm sure it's super exciting. Little pin pokey device to actually get your SIM card inside. Lovely stuff. Two-pin plug because this is a European review model. But obviously you get three-pin if you get it here in the UK. And we got the USB cable. Yay! And that's your lot. Yeah, that was thrilling. Let's just chuck that over to the side. It's not quite as sexy as the Honor 9 box, but then it's a more affordable phone. So what do you expect? But the phone itself, that's what we're all interested in. So let's do a bit of a tour, get it all set up, and have a bit of a play around. So as you can see, your typical Honor smartphone rocks the 18:9 screen. So it's a stretched aspect ratio compared with the old 16:9 Honor 9. And yeah, it looks very similar to the likes of the Honor 7X and the Honor V10, some other phones, especially the Honor V10, which also had an 18:9 screen, of course. Let's just peel off this little plastic sheath on the back here and have a bit of a check out of that lovely glass design. So it's not quite as premium, unfortunately, as the Honor 9. It doesn't have those same lovely curves, but still looks rather fine. This is, of course, the lovely blue model. This is kind of like their flagship colour. Looks very, very stunning indeed. Although, as I say, it's kind of lost those premium elements, so it definitely looks more of an affordable handset. But still a glass finish. Hopefully it'll be a bit more resistant to damage compared with the Honor 9. Stay tuned for a full comparison as well. We'll be doing that to go live at the same time as this unboxing video. You might see the old rear-mounted fingerprint sensor there as well. So just like some of the other recent Honor phones that we've played with, right there in the middle, just to break up that lovely sheen, that lovely glossy design. Ever so slightly jutting camera lenses there as well. It's a dual lens camera. We're going to have a play around with that in a bit too. If we go down below, you'll see Siri, your personal assistant. Oh. Thanks, Siri, just invading my video. Cheers, mate. I don't know what all... it's just been recording everything that I've been saying. Thanks, mate. So as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, if you look down below, you'll see a micro USB charging slot, single mono speaker grill, and you do get a 3.5mm headphone jack as well. Over here on the side, you get your SIM tray slot, which can also hold a bit of micro SD memory card action. Nothing up top, nice and bare. And then on the side, you get your power button and your volume button. And that is the design. Let's just punch in that that power button and see if we've got any juice. Yes, we do. Bit of gas in the tank. So let's get it all set up and everything. And we'll go through the specs and the interface and everything as well. So you can get it in black and grey as well, I should mention. Glacier grey, I believe they call it. Just to funk it up a bit more. And it's got some reasonable heft to 149 grams. So it's reasonably lightweight. But doesn't feel like cheap or toy-like or anything either, so that's always good. And of course, a Motion UI, as you saw, just flash up there. It is the latest version of a Motion UI, Motion UI 8, on top of a nice bit of Android Oreo, so I'll have a bit of a flick around the interface. But we have, of course, done a full hands-on with Android Oreo and with Motion UI 8, so go check out those if you want to know more. All right, connected to our good quality network, excellent, that's what we'd like to hear. Just going to do a quick check for updates. Should be absolutely bang up to date. You can, of course, register with Huawei in order to get your warranty action on the go and all the rest, and transfer your data across as well. We're just going to set it up as a brand new shiny smartphone. Enable a bit of cloud action to back up all your stuff. And here we go, fingerprint touch control as well. So one of the benefits of that rear-mounted fingerprint sensor is the fact that you can, for instance, swipe down in order to show the notifications panel. You can flip around in your gallery. It's not really particularly bad. Sometimes the swiping down for the notifications bar can be quite good, but other times you just hit it by accident, and it can be really annoying. So it kind of depends on what your own personal preferences are. Just got to get fingerprint enrolled super quick. This is normally a nice, fast process, just tapping your finger against that sensor, and it should be done very shortly. There we go. And then, no, I don't want any of your popular apps. Thank you very much. Go away. skip with the Google Assistant. And here we go. Hopefully, we should be into the actual phone interface. Hooray! Nice bubbly wallpaper there. Very nice. Right, so one of the first things I always do with a new Huawei or on a phone is dive into the settings. And then if we go to display, and then jump into home screen style, and I just want my apps tray back, please. So then we can tidy up the desktops. Don't have to have everything cluttered there on the screen, which is definitely very, very lovely. And like all Huawei and Honor phones, of course, it is fully customizable. You can play around with the desktops. If we just get in here, you can change the wallpaper, play with some widgets. You can even fiddle around with the transitions and stuff like that. Play around with the app icons. Loads of stuff that you can mess around with. Just check out our full, as I say, our Motion UI hands-on stuff if you want to know more about all of that. And thankfully, now that we've got that apps tray down there, we can get rid of all of these pesky apps that are cluttering up the desktop. So of course, you get loads of stuff, as you would expect from a Huawei slash Honor phone. So you get random crap like booking.com, stuff like that on there, bit of eBay action, Disney Kingdoms. But you also get some Honor stuff as well. So for instance, the phone clone one, which is where you can copy data stuff. Phone Manager is actually pretty good. If you just want to give it a quick cleanup, get rid of some of the stuff in the cache. You can even scan for viruses and block some annoying people if you want to do a bit of that. So that's always handy, especially if you get called by as many annoying spammers as I do. Always a good thing to get rid of them. There's a tips and tricks section as well. If you're new to Honor, Huawei, Motion UI, all that kind of stuff, you can dive into there and get lots of little helpful hints about how to get the most out of your smartphone. Or, of course, you could just watch our full tips and tricks guides, which are even better. Ding dong ding. So nothing too surprising on the software side there. But in terms of the hardware, what do you actually get for your not much, hopefully, cash? Well, it's 5.65-inch IPS display, and as I said before, it's full 18:9 aspect ratio, so as you can see, it pretty much fills that front panel, just like the Honor V10. And it's certainly, for what is supposed to be an affordable phone, definitely seems to be on the money right now. Reasonably sort of punchy, not like bright, in-your-face, vibrant visuals, but the colours definitely don't look dull or anything either. Viewing angles certainly seem to be absolutely fine. And if we just bump up the brightness as well, take it off auto. Yep, that is definitely eye-searingly bright. So that'll do the job if you're outdoors, if you want something that's going to be nice and visible. That will certainly do the job. Let's just scale that down again, otherwise I'll be blinding you all back home. So it's a 2160 by 1080 as well, pixel resolution. So that means nice full HD, or FHD plus as they call it now, to accommodate that extra bit of screen space. And of course as well, because you've got that stretched aspect ratio, not every app supports it, but luckily you've got the full display mode to sort that out. So here we go. So for instance, Facebook, for some reason, still doesn't support 18:9. But you get this little full screen display here at the bottom. You just give that a little tap, and what that'll do is it'll just kind of zoom in a bit, and it'll give you a nice full screen experience, so you don't get that annoying little bar at the bottom. And it seems to work really, really well. We haven't noticed any irritating cropping or anything occurring when using that feature before, so definitely a good one to do. So what's actually running the show? Well, it's a Kirin 659, so a bit of a pare down of the specs compared to the original flagship. But hopefully it'll do all right. It's backed by 3 gigs of RAM, so again, about half the amount you get in the Honor 9. But so far, touch wood, seems to be reasonably nippy. Once we actually start playing around with apps, we'll test out some games. I know it's a bit of Assassin's Creed action on there to begin with. We'll see how it holds up. Hopefully it should be all right, though. The Kirin 659 generally does a reasonable job, certainly with everyday use, web browsing, messaging, all that kind of stuff. You'll have absolutely no problem whatsoever. And in terms of the storage, I believe you get 32 gigabytes of storage packed away inside. So I'll say the official specs. Yep, there you go, 32 gigs, and just over 22 gigs is free. So just under 10 gigs has already been used up by apps and the OS, which is unsurprising given how much is stuffed on here already. So if you are going to want to download a lot of tracks from Spotify, movies from Netflix, things like that, you'll probably want to get a micro SD slotted into that side flap there. And it does support cards up to 256 gigs, so you're basically covered, no worries. If you're going to be on the road a lot, you'll be reasonably thankful to hear that there's a 3000 milliamp battery packed inside the Honor 9 Lite as well. If you dive into the battery settings, of course, you get all your usual battery setup in here. You can see exactly what's been using your battery, which is handy if you find that it's been getting sucked a little bit faster than you'd expect. You can, of course, change the screen resolution as well if you want to. Knock that down a bit to save some power. And you do have the power saving mode and the ultra power saving mode too, which is pretty good. So the ultra power saving mode is if you're like down to the serious dregs, that just culls everything apart from the most essential features. And as you'll see, you get almost 3 days of life from half a charge on that. So that'll keep you going. And power saving mode, that just helps to knock out some of the things like GPS when you don't need it, stuff like that. Just to get a few extra hours when needed. So what about that camera tech? Well, let's boost it up. As you can see, that's the usual introduction by Honor / Huawei. So let's just get all those allowed. And of course it is, as I said earlier, a dual lens snapper. It's a 13 megapixel primary lens backed by a 2 megapixel secondary lens. So a very typical setup for this company when it comes to the more affordable devices. And that second lens, all it basically does is just gives you a sense of depth, increases the depth of field of your photos, so you can get some nice snaps on the go. Let's get a subject. Right, Mr. Teddy is going to be our model. Thank you, Mr. Teddy. Clutching a lovely bouquet of roses there. So as you see, he's got reasonably fast focus there. If you just focus away, focus back. Seems to do the job there. You can, of course, manually focus if you want to. And because of that depth of field, you can, of course, get a bit of wider aperture mode on the go. And all that does is basically adds a nice bit of a bokeh effect to your photos. You can change how extreme it is, boost it all the way up, and then just get it about there. And hopefully in the photo, you should have a nice blurred background, just help Mr. Teddy to stand out that little bit more. And you can, of course, get a bit of portrait mode action on the go as well. And what that does is it kind of combines wide aperture mode with beauty modes. So you can get Mr. Teddy looking super, super sexy. Oh yeah, work it for me, baby. And it's good to see a nice bit of moving pictures mode on there as well. So just like the live photos mode on Apple's iPhones, it just shoots a little video snippet as you take your photo. So it takes a little bit longer, as you can see there. But then that just sort of brings it to life in the galleries. It's not quite as smooth and slick an experience as you get on Apple's phones, but it does the job. And of course, because it's Huawei / Honor, you've got a whole bunch of extra bonus camera features to play with. So for instance, you get full manual controls, whether you're in photo mode or video mode. So you can play around with the likes of ISO levels, all that kind of stuff. Just get that rid of that with a quick tap there. We scroll across again, you've got panorama, of course. HDR is still its own separate mode, which is kind of annoying rather than having it in the auto mode, although it doesn't seem to make much difference anyway, to be perfectly honest. Light painting mode, of course, which has been on every Huawei Honor phone for a good long while. Time-lapse video and stuff like that. So yeah, your standard set of bonus camera modes. And of course, you swipe this way, you get into all your other camera settings. You can go, as you see, up to 30 megapixel resolution photos. You can add GPS action, bit of watermark. You got assistive grids, touch to capture, capture smiles, object tracking, loads of settings to play around with. And if you dive into the video, this should shoot up to full HD video, I believe it was, the spec says. We just go into resolution. Yeah, full HD, 1080p by default. There is no option by the looks of it for 60 frames per second or 4K. So that's a bit of a shame, but never mind. And of course, you can do object tracking and things like that as well. So plenty of stuff to play around with. And it looks like you got a good bit of the beauty mode on the video too. So if you're shooting a movie of someone looking a little bit rough, as I normally do, then that's a good feature to have. And then rounding off the camera specs is a 13 megapixel and 2 megapixel front facing camera as well. So again, you just get that nice depth of field for your selfies and everything. I'm not going to turn that on now because I probably look like a freaking mutant right now. So let's just leave that alone. But yes, again, same camera specs up front, with the beauty mode and the portrait mode and everything enabled too. So you can shoot some really nice looking selfies. Shoot some really nice looking selfies. And that, in a nutshell, is the Honor 9 Lite. So it looks like your typical affordable Honor, really, to be perfectly honest. Yeah, decent little size, despite the fact it's got a pretty spacious screen, thanks to that 18:9 aspect ratio. Some reasonable specs. I'm sure it'll be absolutely fine for your everyday user, and hopefully you should be able to play some like games and all that kind of stuff as well. And with any luck, the camera will be fine. I'm expecting it to be not great for low light shots, but absolutely fine for everything else. And hopefully the full HD video will have a decent bit of stabilization for a change, so won't be too juddery when you're shooting and moving at the same time. So stay tuned for our full camera review and in-depth review. I'm going to do a comparison right now with the Honor 9 as well. Any other phones you want me to compare with, like the likes of the V10, just give me a shout, and I will try my best to do that, because I love you fine people. So see you all later. Love you. Bye.